Namaste, one and all. Welcome you to the series of presentation on National Education Policy 2020. And today, I am going to present the topic Proposed Organizations in National Education Policy 2020. So there are 14 different organizations at state as well as national level are proposed in the new policy, and two of them entirely for school education and 12 organizations for higher education. So let us see those one by one. The first organization, PEREC, it's meant for school education. It's as a national assessment center. PEREC, to evaluate, is the national assessment center to be established. It will be a standard setting body on student assessment throughout the country, throughout the all different boards of education in various states, and it will guide achievement surveys of state as well as national levels. Then it will encourage shifting of prioritization of assessment towards assessing 21st century skills, and it also enable the state boards to share their best practices in assessment. So that is the first organization. It's for school level education. So assessment is planned or proposed as a comprehensive reform in school assessment. And the second one is State School Standards Authority, SSSA. It's an authority. This authority also set standards for educational institutions throughout the state in consultation with NCERT. NCERT will develop the standards for each state, and the standards with respect to safety, security, infrastructure, teachers, their grades, financial aspects, all such things, as well as the governance of schools. Such a comprehensive standards for various aspects of school at state level. So there should be a school quality assessment and accreditation framework, or a framework may be developed at state level for accreditation of schools in every state. So these are the two main organizations at school level. Now we are pass on to that higher education organizations. The first one is Multidisciplinary Education and Research University. So a specific category of universities termed as MERU, Multidisciplinary Education and Research Universities, will be established at various parts of the nation. It should be at par with IITs, IIMs, etc. And it aimed to attain highest global standards in quality education. So it's a type of new type of organization shall be established, Multidisciplinary Education and Research University. Then National Mission for Mentoring, that's a mission, and it is constituted by willing outstanding senior and retired faculty including languages to provide short and long mentoring or professional support to university and college teachers. So it's a mission, that's another important organization in order to enable teachers. Then National Research Foundation, it's a new organization. It's in the area of research in higher education to enable a culture of research. So that's the major aim of this organization. And it provide fund through peer-reviewed process. And it also seed and grow research at state universities and other institutions where research capacity capability is limited. So that's another aim of this NRF, and it will competitively fund research in all disciplines. So there will be a competitive funding. That means there shall be proper procedure for acquiring as well as spending within the time span, etc., of research funds. So there shall be a provision for competitive funding. A new National Research Foundation is going to establish. The apex body, the Higher Education Commission of India, will be the apex body of higher education in India. It should act as an overarching autonomous umbrella body. It's termed in the, described in the policy such as it's an umbrella body which is supported by four verticals. So the underlying principle of this organization, Higher Education Commission, is that it's a faceless, transparent regulatory intervention using technology. So it's a technology mediated transparent regulatory system, and it regulate cover the four major areas such as regulation, accreditation, funding and standard setting of higher education. So in order to make this function realize, the four different organizations are also going to establish as four verticals of this Higher Education Commission of India. They are National Higher Education Regulatory Council, NHERC, National Accreditation Council, NAC, Higher Education Grants Council, HEGC, and General Education Council. So these four pillars of Higher Education Commission of India, and on the four pillars, this commission will act as an umbrella, and it is explained as a transparent, faceless regulatory intervention using technology. The National Higher Education Regulatory Council, a single point regulator for all higher education sector except medical and legal education. So this is the nature of the body. It will control all higher education, all type of higher education institutions except medical and legal, and will set up to regulate light but tight and facilitative manner. So there shall be regulations that will be developed by this regulatory council. Offline and online public self-disclosure. So this regulation will demand institutions to disseminate all details of their programs, their expenditure, their outcomes, etc., through the website of NHERC as well as the institution website. It's a part of public auditing also. So in such a way that this regulatory council is going to intervene in higher education. Then National Accreditation Council, we have already a National Assessment and Accreditation Council, and here it is termed as NAC. So it aimed to facilitate the process of accreditation of higher education, and also in the case of this NAC, also self disclosure is the primary aim or primary duty that each type of institution should do. All these things should be supervised by NAC, and soon after, benchmarks for all types of higher educations will be set up, and institutions should achieve those quality benchmark, and all higher education institutions will aim through their institutional development plans. So an institutional development plan for next 15 years shall be developed by individual institutions, and the NAC will supervise the progress of institution through these years. then Higher Education Grants Council, the third vertical of the Higher Education Commission of India. It supervises the criterion-based funding and financing of higher education. So it's a new body for funding and financing of higher educations, and that funding will be on the basis of institutional development plans and its progress made on their implementation. Not only plans, but the progress of implementation also will be evaluated, and only on the basis of that further funds will be sanctioned. So this HEGC has another function, such as disbursement of scholarship and developmental fund for new focus areas and expanding quality programs of higher education institution across discipline and across the country. So it's a new funding and financing agency. Then there is a General Education Council, GEC, and this General Education Council will frame expected learning outcomes for higher education programs, all types of programs such as degree, diploma, certificate, whatever program is there, and this GEC will set quality standards, the learning outcomes, specify the outcomes such as graduate attributes. So a national higher education qualification framework will be formulated by GEC, and it includes such learning outcomes for all types of programs. And this GEC will be mandated to identify specific skills to be attained through various academic programs. So it's a purely academic nature, this GEC, and these four are the four verticals of Higher Education Commission. Then there are other organizations such as Professional Standard Setting Bodies, PSSBs. So there are various institutions already. We have ICAR, VCI, NCTE, COA, NCVET, etc. All these organizations were renamed as, and they have their functions also modified as only standard setting bodies. They are no more have the regulatory function. They only have to set the professional standard in respective areas. So they are able to draw curricula, then they have to fix academic standard in the specific discipline. They have to give outlines for, framework for teaching, research, extension, learning, etc. in the corresponding domains. And this PSSB will be a member in GEC, General Education Council. So these PSSBs will provide further details of academic programs in various disciplines. Then Board of Governors. The Board of Governors will be set up in each individual institution, and such a Board of Governors will be the highest body of all institutions as proposed by this policy. And this BOG will supervise all activities regarding the institution, including its appointments and all other developmental decision, everything. So such a body is another organization. Then Indian Institute of Translation and Interpretation, IITI, that's a new proposal, new organization. And this institution is meant to develop multilingual languages as well as classical Indian languages, then translation and interpretation of various Indian languages. And this shall be extensively use of technology for translation and interpretation. And this will not be a unitary institution, and this institution shall be housed in multiple locations in future. So it is planned like that, there can be this Translation and Interpretation Institute at various parts of our country in near future. Then National Education Technology Forum, that's another organization, NETF, and this technology forum, which is so significant in the present context as the entire system of education is now moving in an online platform. So such a technology forum is highly essential, and the education policy, new education policy, aim to establish such a forum, and it's a platform for free exchange of ideas on use of technology, and it will facilitate decision making on induction, deployment and use of technology, provide independent evidence-based advice to central and state government agencies on technology-based interventions. Then the NETF build intellectual and institutional capacities, then strategic thirst areas in this domain, articulate new directions for research and innovation. So it's a very significant institution in the present context. So that's a brief outline of various organizations, the 14 different organizations mentioned in the new education policy 2020. So thanks for watching the presentation. Thank you all.